You want to create your own custom radio station in City Skylines? Well, I got you covered. Let's see what you're gonna need first. Well, the first thing you're gonna need, which is pretty obvious, is the game itself, Cities Skylines. Next, we're gonna need the CSL Music Mod. For that, we go to the City Skylines Steam Workshop and we search CSL Music Mod. And it should be the first to appear. We click on it and we subscribe to it. Now, this mod, you will not need it right away, but you'll need it to test your radio station and run it. Now, in order to actually create your radio station, you're gonna need a tool called CSL Music Mod Station Editor. You can get this in two ways, and I'm gonna explain each and every one of them. The first way to get the mod is from the City Skylines Steam Workshop. You search for CSL Music Mod Station Editor, and it should be the first result. You don't actually need to have the game running in order to use this tool, but you need to have the game installed in order for Steam to download the files. So you subscribe to it, and in order to use the tool, you have to find it within the workshops folders on your PC. And you have some possible paths here in the mod description. It can be at either C, program files, Steam, Steam apps, workshop, content, games ID, and the mods ID. Or your drive, Steam, Steam apps, workshop, content, games ID, the mods ID. Or Steam library instead of Steam. It all depends on how you created your folders and where you installed Cities Skylines. In my case, I have it on E, Steam, Steam apps, workshop, content. This is the game's ID 255710. And now we should search for the mod's ID, which should be this one, 273144337. And there you go. These are the files you need to work with, more exactly the executable. The second place you can get this tool from is GitHub. I have the link in the video description, but if you want, you can also type it. It will be github.com, Mr. Not So Evil, CSL Music Mod Station Creator. And here you'll have the possibility to download it. You go to releases here, and you pick the zip file. You save it wherever you want. I'm just gonna save it in the downloads folder. And now that I have downloaded it, I'm just gonna go ahead and extract it here. You can extract it wherever you wish. I'm just gonna move it later. You enter that folder and there you go. These are the files you need, more exactly the executable you need in order to create the custom radio stations in Cities Skylines. Before you start the app, there's one more thing you need, and that brings us to the next step. You need to download and install Java Runtime 8 or higher. Now, if you have it installed, you can skip this part. You have the download link in the video description, but if you want, you can also type it java.com/download. And you press the huge button in the middle of the screen. You can open it directly. Install. Wait for the installer to finish. You have successfully installed Java. Now you can close the installer and you can run the app. Which brings us to the next step of our tutorial, start the station editor. Now you go back to the folder where you extracted the zip file and you double click the executable. And this is how the station editor looks. Now it's time to create your first radio station. For that we go back to the app and we need to type in a name. In my case, that will be Grand Theft Auto 2. After the name, you need to type in a description. I'll just copy paste mine here. Now, this is not really necessary if you plan to use the radio station only for yourself. But if you plan to upload it on the Steam Workshop, this description will appear in the content manager. And next, we need to set up a thumbnail. We press this little button here. We go to the folder where we have our thumbnail. And there we go. It's really important to mention that you should have a square thumbnail. Otherwise, it will look funny and not okay at all. Now, we need to create a collection of songs or audio files. And for that, we go to the Collections tab right here. As you can see, we have no collections yet. We can add one by clicking this button here. And we need to name the collection. I'll just put in test, as I'll want to get back to it later. Modify something. And now, in order to add the songs, you need to edit the collection. But if you try to do it now, you'll get this message. You need to save your radio station first. For that, we go to File, Save, and we're gonna look for the folder where I downloaded the app. And I'm just gonna save it here. Now you can start adding the music files. Now, it's very important you should know the audio files need to be in OGG format. So if you have MP3 files, you can't add those. You need to convert them first. And I'll show you how. If you already have the OGG files, you can skip the next two parts of this tutorial. But if you don't, then you need to get an audio converter. For that, I suggest WinLame, which you can get from winlame.sourceforge.io. Press this download button here, then proceed to downloading the installer from here. Gonna save it. Gonna save it in the download. Now I'm gonna run the installer. Yes, I know Windows is protecting my PC. Run anyway. Next. I agree. Next. Next. So now you can check this to launch the converter right away and press finish. Now let's convert the files. As I said, you need to convert your audio files to the OGG format. For that, we'll have WinLame opened and the folder with our songs. And we'll just select our files and we're gonna drag and drop them into WinLame. Yes, these are the files. Next, you change the output mode to OGG Vorbis encoder. The output folder is exactly where I want it to be, so no change here. Just gonna go ahead and click next. The quality, I'm just gonna leave it like that. Next. And WinLame is warning us that there might be a quality loss during the conversion. Okay, finish. Now we wait for the files to be converted. Once they are completed, we can start importing them into the station editor. And in order to do that, we go back to the station editor. And now that we saved our station, we can click on edit, then click the add button. And we go where we have our OGG files. We select them all and click open. And there you go. These are all our files. As you can see, the content type for them is set to music. If you click on edit, you can change their content type to, I don't know, commercial, talk. Maybe you want to make talk radio. You can do that if you want. But since mine are all songs, I'll just leave them to music and I'll close this. And now it's time to save the radio station and export it as a Cities Skylines mod. We go to File, Save, then we go to Tools, Export to Local Mod Folder. And that's it. The radio station has been created. All we have to do now is get into the game and test our radio station. First, we go to the Content Manager, Mods. And here is our brand new radio station. We turn it on. We close this. We either start a new game or load our save game. And now we go here. And in this list, we should have our new radio station. And what do you know? It's actually working. So there you have it. Now, there's one more optional step if you want to export your radio station to the Steam Workshop and share it to the whole Cities Skylines community. You have to go to the Content Manager, Mods, find your mod again, and click on Share. Now, for the title, this is how it will appear in the Steam Workshop, but you can also change this later. Same goes for the descriptions. So I'm just gonna write in progress. As for the thumbnail, this is the only place where you can change it, and you have to click this little icon here, and this will be your thumbnail. So basically what you need to do is replace this one with your own, which I have here. You have to make sure the name is the same. So I'm gonna copy this over here, replace, and yes, make sure it's a square one because it will look better, even if here does not look so well. Next thing you need to do is just publish. And so your radio station has been published to the Steam Workshop. You can go and change visibility to unlisted if you want, until you put the proper description and edit anything else here. So I hope by now you know how to make your custom radio station for Cities Skylines. If there's anything you did not understand from my tutorial, please let me know in the comments. And you can also let me know in the comments what kind of radio station are you planning to do. And if this tutorial has been helpful to you, don't forget to like my video and subscribe to my channel. Cheers!